First, in this race to 15, we are now at a total of 14 sets today, Chiki Pablo.
Buti na lang merong tapaking. Diba? Energized us.
Maghahanap ulit-ulit tayo niyan mamaya. Fifth set underway, race to 15. Here is Dolorito. Gets the first point of the fifth.
Si Dolorito, when she goes up for the kill, alam mo yung buong katawan niya, she's giving it her all. That's why yung last niya na palo, lumabas yung bola.
Dolorito had a field day in the third set. Cepada!
Pero ganun din si Cepada eh. Nakita niya yung dalawang blockers in front of her. Hindi na niya i-challenge yun. Gagamitin na lang niya. She went off the block.
Tandaan mo, Cepada did not play the whole second set.
That's right.
Came in late in the third. Was also benched the majority of the first set. They need her offense now.
Good up.
Balingit across. Puzon adjusting. Dolorito off the block. Oh, double contact is going to be called on Dinigalia.
Mababa din niya kinuha yung bola eh.
2-1 LPU. Joanne Duguna has given it her all today. So has this young lady. Si Jonah Dolorito. Quick set.
Wow.
To the back for Kai Cepada.
Ang ganda nung set ni Madriaga. It was near the net at yun ang gusto ni Cepada.
Madriaga has made everybody happy sa panig ng Lady Warriors today. Combination, red late. Guzman, Duguna off the block. Back set ngayon for Tinicalia!
Mahirap talaga i-receive ang ball when you're running and you're receiving it overhead. Walang control yun eh. That's why the coaches would always say, square your shoulders towards the hitter. Kailangan planted ang both feet.
Apple naman para dito sa UE. Balingit, galing likod.
Inside.
The line.
Inside.
And a challenge from Tom Garcia. It looked in. It really looked in.
It really looked in.
So ball in, ball out now for Lyceum of the Philippines University. Also has Coach Crom talking to the girls. Nakakawa naman yung nandun sa koral ng UE. Bawal umupo.
Oo nga, pati dito. Sa LPU. Kaya,
wala naman ang nakaupo eh. In, out.
Inside.
In. Walang kaduda-duda. It really looked in from the first time we saw it. So, mababawasan ng isang challenge si Crom Garcia. Down kailangan, to one.
Kailangan talaga susundan mo yung bola eh before letting it go.
Yeah. Lady Red Warriors now up two. They play at Jaja Tulang.
Ang bilis din naman ang bawi. That was a good first ball from Dolorito.
Tulang started out as a middle blocker, moved to the opposite position. And now Hiro Osada. Madriaga, quick back set. Papunta naman dito kay Cepada.
What a hit by Cepada. She was on top of that ball.
The
ganda
flying
timing.
Bigyan natin siya ng pangalan na. The Flying Kai.
Pwede.
As we see, this Jiangnan hot pot attack. Hot pot ba? Attack nga sa Jiangnan. Pa Gianni Barrientos, the Flying A. Ito the Flying Kai.
Oh, pwede. Oh!
Nabitin ang flight ni Flying Kai. UE 5, LPU 4. Tulang. At Triaga still forcing it to Tinacalia, and it works. Alangani na papunta kay Ekalia, pati tinuloy pa rin nila.
Ang ganda ng palo ni Ekalia, alam niya kung sinong ita-target, kung anong zone.
Yes, Arojo. Arojo, you know, she has not sat down since coming in the second set.
So she's been performing.
Started out the second set as an outside spiker, then moved into middle. That's where she is now.
Sharp serve.
Oh. Sino? Dolorito.
Good dig.
Oh! Second time that's happened to Tinacalia. Pawis na si Joanne Duguna. And she has taken off the bandage, which is a good thing. Kanina, balot na balot yung kanyang kanang daliri, kanyang thumb area. Balingit, yes.
Balingit hitting the floor on zone 6. Si Guzman was there, kaya lang, kinulang lang ng isang step forward.
There's very few mistakes for Blue Guzman today. Ekalia with a service error.
Dalawa na ang service error ng UE.
7-all. And now Angel Cruz.
It's over.
Over received. Oh, Dolorito will give LPU the lead at the changeover. This game will not end. I'm already telling you. This game will not end. We will be playing here all the way until Halloween.
It is bound to end at 15. Pero yun lang, gaano katagal?
Diba nakuwento ko sa longest set I ever covered? Fifth set, ha?
Oh.
Longest ever?
Ano?
32-30.
Oh, wow. Longest men's, women's?
Set. Women's.
Wow.
Oh, that was 2011. Sa V-League din yun. That was a game between Perpetual Help and the Maynila Water Dragons, as we see where LPU is now. If they win, they will finally get into the win column and drag UE down with them.
Yeah.
But if UE wins, they'll be at 500 and move up to fourth place. Kaya lang nabawasan ng isang puntos kung sino man nanalo rito.
Oh, kasi umabot tayo ng fifth set.
Look at the errors so far in this matchup. Courtesy of our Cantigo scoreboard, UE with 5 already. That is in. Can they challenge for antenna touch?
Yeah. Ang sinasabi nila, ang sinasabi ng players, it hit the antenna.
So it is an antenna touch challenge. That was close though.
Yeah. Parang so, hindi. Pero let's see.
Yeah, that was close from where we were. Tingin ko rin wala.
Oo.
Pero, again, masyado mabilis yung tama ng bola.
Correct, correct. Mabuti nang may challenge para ma-sure tayo.
I can see in the background si Cassie Donggalio sa likod, hoping that this challenge goes in their favor.
Wala. It just bounced off the tape.
Yep. So what is that? Wala nang challenge ang LPU.
Oh, wow.
That is a telling blow now.
Well, I hope na lang nila, no, na they won't need a challenge.
Second referee Ryan Vincent Corpus confirming na wala nang challenge ang LPU. Coach Crom, tanggap na. Now they have to play and hope, as Chiki said, na walang kakailanganin ng challenge. Casey Balingin. Who's on? And the combination works, or the straight up shot for Osada works. LPU now on top.
Yeah, you know, Osada, sure siya sa mga tira niya. Even if there were blockers, makita natin hindi synchronized yung pagtalo ng blockers, kaya nakalusot yung bola niya.
Madriaga now going to Kai Cepeda again. Or Kai Cepeda when she decides to take over.
Yeah. You know, she hits the ball from the top. Kaya yung trajectory ng bola niya very sharp pababa.
Sub here for UE as Zamudio is going to come back in to serve for Risa Nogales. And that also gives the Lady Red Warriors an extra libero. She's in there. That's why she's called the serve specialist.
You know, kanina pa tina-target si Tulang.
So she is gonna try it again. Lady Red Warriors now up. Another sharp one. Adriaga, Cepeda, go! And Cepeda did go!
Ganda ng wrist action kasi ni Cepeda eh. Kaya dalam-dala niya yung bola pababa.
Timeout LPU. As we see this one again, from the excellent floor defense to the execution.
Paluin eh. Hindi nga makamatay yung patsyo kasi nga naka-establish sila ng ganyan. Diba? Naka-commit sila doon sa didepensahan nila eh. Papatayin ba natin ng gano'n lang? Paluin na mahaba kung gusto gano'n na lang. Kung gano'n kalambot rin light, tapon na mahaba eh. Kumit na sa pasa. Nakukuha. Pero pinakamaayos mumasa, dapat ikaw yung sumasarado dyan.
Oh, let's go. Please.
Tatlong sunod na yan para dito sa UE. They were actually down at the changeover 8-7. Then Zamudio comes in.
Yeah.
Beatrice Zamudio.
I think she's gonna target zone 5.
Zone 6, pumunta. Hoy! Oh, that's a delayed call but a correct call. Hold on, it goes against LPU. I thought it was gonna be reaching beyond the net against Rojo. Pero illegal block daw si Osada. Or whoever it was in the back. Was it Puzon? It will go. I want to see that one again. Si Puzon yata tatawagan ng illegal block dito eh. They need clarification. This is a big point. Pasangga ba siya? Kasi kung pasangga siya, it's not supposed to be. Coach Crom still disagrees. Tanda natin, Crom Garcia is also a setter.
Oh, tama na raw, sabi ng referee. So now, baka may yellow card pa si Coach Crom.
And UE heads into a service error. So they leave Zamudio at the back. And the Lady Red Warriors are going to use a timeout, up by 2.
I have 2 timeouts, calling it to slow down the game, let her think about it, alright? On our side, we have received a pass. Skeezy sets the ball, we put it away, we're at 13, alright? One pass. Finish.
Stop!
When they see themselves on screen, biglas na tumatalikod.
Nagsasmile muna, tapos tumatalikod.
Down by 2, Lady Pirates. Jonah Dolorito. Look at the attack points in this set for UE.
Wow.
Courtesy of our Cantigo score. Error number 2. Tama ba ako? Error number 2.
Oo, for LPU.
Last time out for the Lady Pirates.
Tatlo. Isban mo na maayos ha. Kumi. Ipitin mo na. Nakukuha. Commitment sa receive. Okay? Then, offense tayo. Okay, one stop, tapos balik tayo ng service. And then,
let's go. Pirates!
Cover mo na blue.
Magandang timeout yun eh. Kasi kailangan makompose mo yung team eh.
Boy, LPU goes on to lose this. Their chances of making it to the playoffs are almost zero now. Tulang gets nice. 1 point back.
That's a nice push to zone two. Nobody was home.
Double attack pa ang binigay doon. And now they're hoping that Hiro Osada is able to get this done. And in the meantime, tatawag ng timeout si Coach Obet. They're also out of timeouts.
Again. One, two, three. Again, wanted to think about about her serve, right? Who do we have passing? Let's go. Ladies, three or four?
Three.
Okay. One pass, a pass, right? A pass, run your plate. I want all hitters to be ready, front row and back row, get ready. Ladies, if you get the ball on this side, down the line. Wide open.
Pass your normal form. Laban tayo, laban!
Trying to keep it slow and trying to freeze Hiro Osada. But that's the last timeout for UE.
Nakita din ni Coach Obet kung saan ang open zone, and I think that's going for down the line to zone 1.
A pass muna.
There
that's
you go.
It. That's the one. Down the line is open. Played off the block, and it is Kai Sepada delivering again. 4 match points for the University of the East. Sepada serving for the match.
Nice serve.
Laguna, Balingit. Will this be it? Yes! Casey Balingit ended the fourth set, and she ends the fifth set as well. University of the East with a hard-fought 5 sets win and virtually eliminating LPU from a future contention into the playoffs.
You know, this was a good match though, even if somebody had to lose, because we had a lot of long rallies. In fact, medyo matagal din yung nangyari dito sa fifth set, 17 minutes, maraming challenges. So, but UE was more composed and they stayed within their system. Kala mo, nawalan na sila ng pag-asa, but you know, Mariaga did a good job in leading her team.
From down 2-1, the University of the East resurrecting as we take a look at the final numbers here in set number 5.
Na-contain talaga ng UE ang LPU with just 5 attack points. So dyan pa lang na-dominate na nila. And kahit na mas konti yung errors ng LPU, sobrang dominated dun sa attacks. And the attacks came from mostly from Sepada, who is our player of the game.
Kai Sepada did not play in the second set. Played sparingly in sets 1 and 3. But from set 4 to set 5, it was the Flying Kai that delivered the goods para dito sa University of the East. It's not how you start, it's how you finish.
Oh yeah, oo. Tsaka itong si Kai kasi parating talagang plays with heart.
And the smile is finally out. Genuine smile yan, hindi smile na ano na kinakabahan or naiirita sa mga